I can see lots of you. Can you see lots of me? Yes, with this thing you can. Well, the year we've got coming up is 2020. And it made me think that 2020 vision and 2020 hindsight, all sorts of uses. So what sort of optical toys have I got which show 2020 and others? So here's a few of them. These are Fresnel lenses. That's a small one, but here's a much bigger one. Look at this. This has got about loads more. Oh, I'm seeing many, many of you this time. When you turn it around, you get a lovely effect too. And here's a big lens at the end too for magnifying, so I like that. And here's another one with round pieces. It's a bit battered at the top, but it's been used by kids for parties for many years now. That's a nice one. And the other way around too. And here's yet one more. Goodness me, look at that. Extraordinary. So lots and lots of Fresnel lenses. But some American designer thought of the idea of doing something else with them. He had an idea that perhaps an inflatable ball should be made of Fresnel lenses. Do you think? Well, let's have a go. If I pump it up, it should make a very, very pretty little beach ball, because the effect is you're getting all these magnification bits and pieces. Made of plastic. I picked this up in, the late 90s when I was visiting the States for the first time. I found it's a very, very pleasing optical effect when it's fully blown up. It's coming into vision there nicely. I don't know how many there are, but there's an awful lot of little windows, each of them which is a little Fresnel lens. Giving the magnification. Oh, there we are. It's almost a full size now. There we are. Look at that. Beautiful. And let's put this cap back on again. That is something else, isn't it? Beautiful idea, that. And it bounces too. Beautiful. Here's another Fresnel lens, which is, it's a bit of fun, this. Oh, yes, look, I can see a backlight in it. Yes. The light behind me, it is a backlight, isn't it? Nice one, that. But it's, it gives a wide angle. That's what that Fresnel lens is. It's beautiful. Incidentally, we gave out in the Christmas pack a couple of years ago a little tiny one, which is typical, a little magnifying glass, which again uses magnify things with it. But it was actually doubled up as a bookmarker. So you put it between the pages when you're reading a book if you need the lens to magnify things. So I like things which have a double purpose, and that's an example of one. And here's a couple more examples of double uses. This, for instance, is a rattleback, a well-known little optical topological toy with an optical properties. It rattles back when it's spun the right way. But it was quickly discovered when they made it of this plastic, not of wood, that when you put it over something with writing in it, it magnifies or diminishes and makes an optical effect. It's a kind of lens, basically. Very nice. So a double purpose to that. Well, here we have something which is not at all clear what it is. It's if I look through it, I can't see very much going on. I see, oh yes, a bit of magnification, but what's all this for? And what's that hole there for? Well, it turns out this is actually, would you believe, yes, a cigarette lighter. If I point this up towards the sun, you can see the illumination there from the studio light. But if that was a hot sun there, that would probably be enough to light the cigarette's tip there. So this is actually a solar-powered cigarette lighter using a lens. Interesting. There's a lens which is popular in the theatres, in cinemas for many years, which helped to widen compressed film into cinema scope size. This thing here, it's extraordinary. It's a cylindrical lens, it's called. But the actual gubbins, a bit inside, is a very funny little bit of glass shaped like this, which is sort of dipped in the middle, and it's not symmetrical. It's got a dip on one side and not the other. Let's put it in front of the camera and you'll just see roughly the effect it's going to give when it makes things look either large or wide one way and narrow the other way. A cylindrical lens. Very interesting effect, there's. Here's a little multiple lens item I got. It's a thing you put in your pocket, and when you want to dial up a lens, you literally do that. And you've got a little knurled wheel here, and as you do it, as you turn these, you'll find you're getting different magnifications of lenses. There's 8 of them all together, all different sizes, all different magnifications. So it's a nice idea for someone who wants to be sure of magnifying something and not sure how strong a lens it is. They've actually got 8 lenses stuck in there, and they can dial up the lens they want. And when you finish with it, you put it in your pocket and put it away. What could be easier? Lovely. I think about that. That's so neat. Here's a very interesting thing. It's I got them originally a sake glass. It looks like an empty glass. Well, it is empty. It's got nothing in it. There's a marble in the base, but there's a picture in the bottom which you can't see. What you need to do is to put some water in there. Well, it should be sake, really. Let's see what happens. So nothing in there is visible. When I put some liquid in there, suddenly, as if by magic, a little creature appears. This is for kids. And when you drink the contents, it disappears again. Wonderful, isn't it? So the water is acting like a lens, like a second lens, to bring the light back into focus again. Very, very nice idea, that. And the last thing to show are these wonderful fibre optic tapers, or fibre optic tubes. They call them image conduits. There's a whole series of bunch of fibre optics there, which carry the light from the base set up to the top surface. It can work either way up, but it works better one way than the other. That's the other way up, but it works best this way up. And when I pass it slowly back over the piece, let's get it up under the colour section over here. There we are, there's some colour coming in as well, which is very nice. That's instrumentation, I think, used in one of the aircraft or missiles or something in the American Science Surplus sold it off. This is an interesting one because it's the same idea, but imagine putting this in the laboratory, heating it up and giving it a twist, 180-degree twist, and that's what happened here. So whatever is in there goes through 180 degrees and basically it turns everything upside down. So it's like a reversing prism, but it's not a prism, it's a lens. A lens which reverses. Wonderful. Very nice and very simple effect. And then they did something quite remarkable by drawing it out so it tapered like this, and they found that it magnified or diminished depending on which way around you did it. So let's put it on this way and you'll find it'll diminish it and make it very, very small. That's a bit small, a bit larger. It's also angle, which is nice. But turn it upside down and it magnifies beautifully. Very, very nice indeed. So the taper magnifies or diminishes depending on which way you do it. And they made a whole lot of these at a department of Harvard University about 10, 15 years ago to try and help people with limited vision. They didn't want to have any of the spherical aberration, they call it, on the edge of the lens. And this one doesn't produce it, but it's expensive to make. It was the main trouble. So a fascinating thing, that. So I do find that lenses to me have always been a source of great fascination. I think lenses. I love them.